test, Mother.
Jess, honey, why are you doing this? I've been through
enough. Mom, seriously, we've been through this like 1,000 times. Do we really have to do this now? I'm literally about to start my first shifts.
Yeah, that's exactly why we have to do this right now.
Mom, I told you I am going to be fine, all right? Most cops go their entire career without seeing any action.
Yeah, Mom, tell that to your father.
Nice.
Well, Jess, for me, don't do this. Hey, do you know what? I got a nice car.
Mom, I'm gonna be really late, so can we talk about this later?
Look, I need to talk about this right now. I can't take this anymore.
No, because I'm gonna be late and I'm gonna be fired before I even get to my first day of work, but I love you. I love you. Goodbye. Goodbye. Hello? Hello? Anybody in here?
How long you been there?
I just walked in. I'm Officer Lowe.
Turn around.
My order said to report.
I said turn around! Stop! I said turn around, not walk away!
Sir?
Sergeant Cohen.
Officer Lauren.
Lauren?
Yes, sir. I was told to report here. It might have been a mistake. I thought the new station was up and running already.
Oh, yes, it is. And she's a fucking beauty. St. Michael himself would be impressed. And tomorrow, when you see it, you will fall down upon his steps and weep. But tonight, you're here.
Sir, I guess I don't understand what I'm doing here.
The real question is, what the hell am I still doing here? Okay, but to answer yours, you are the lucky rookie to work the very last shift in this mausoleum. All 911 calls have been rerouted to the new station, so it should be quiet. Okay, you may have some walk-ups, but just send them up the street. Mm-hmm. The address and my number are on the wall. If there's an emergency, call the station. There's the kitchen and the weight room down the hall if you get bored. That's Holden. You don't have to go down there.
It's Sarge, can I speak frankly?
Sure.
Why am I here and not a security guard?
Let's go, rookie!
Yes, sir.
This room contains enough hazardous material to make Chernobyl look like fucking bird shit on a windowsill. Tonight, every hardened criminal in this area will do everything in their power to get to this, and you're the only one standing between them and the total annihilation of this fucking city. I'm messing with you, rookie.
Oh, yeah. I know.
It's not in the department's policy to hire outside security when we have a whole fleet of blue bloods on the payroll.
Right.
And the only thing left in these cabinets are some needles, some blood-stained, shit-stained clothes, basically all the vile crap that we collect from perps and crime scenes that have made their way through evidence and we can't throw in the trash. The material was supposed to be disposed of yesterday, but for whatever reason, it wasn't. So Hazmat's gonna be here sometime between 10 p.m. and 4 a.m. Do not leave. I repeat, do not leave the premises. Understood?
Yes, sir.
I'll be back to relieve you when your shift is over. Any questions?
No, sir.
Stanford Police Department.
Hello?
Help me. I'm trapped.
I'm sorry, you're trapped. Are you injured?
The screams have all stopped now.
Okay, ma'am, just stay calm. What's your address?
I think they might all be dead.
All right, ma'am, just give me your address and I'll dispatch a unit to your location. Hello? Ma'am? Oh shit.
Stanford Police Department.
Yeah, this is Officer Lauren. I just received a distress call at the old station. It was a possible 1054. I was told all emergency calls were rerouted, so...
All calls were rerouted.
Well, they weren't, because I just received one.
Is the line still active?
No.
Were you able to obtain any of the VIX information?
No, sir. The line was disconnected. Hello?
I've documented the call, and I'll confirm on my end that the line's been properly rerouted.
All right. All right, thank you. Sergeant Cohen? Sergeant Cohen, is that you, sir? Oh. Sir, you have to leave. The station is closed. Sir. Sir, if you don't leave the station now, I'm going to be forced to tase. Sir, you know where you are? Sir, you're in a police station. Hey. Hello?
Sir!
Jesus Christ. Move. Move! Get out. Get out! Sanford Police Department.
Please. I need to get out.
Hey, you called earlier, right? What's your name?
Monica.
Monica? Okay, Monica, where are you?
I was brought to a ranch.
A ranch? All right. Do you know the address?
They're coming back.
Okay, tell me quickly, is there anything around you that you could help me locate you? Anything that you see? What's near you? Pigs? All right, is there anything else?
I have to go.
Monica. Damn it. Monica?
I think I may have the wrong number. This is Joe from BioClean Waste Removal.
Oh, no. I'm sorry. This is Officer Lauren. I was expecting you.
Just, I want to give you a heads up. We're running a little behind, you know. I thought we'd be there sooner, but we're dealing with quite a mess here.
Okay, so what is it going to be, more like 4?
Sure, maybe sooner, but I tell you what, I'll call you back if things change.
All right, that's fine. Thank you, Joe.
Sanford Police Department.
Yeah, this is Officer Lauren. I'm calling again from the old station. I keep receiving 911 calls.
All calls have been rerouted.
Yeah, I know. I called earlier to report the same issue.
Are you receiving a high volume of calls?
No, it's not a high volume of calls. She's called twice. It's the same girl. Her name is Monica. She's definitely in some kind of danger. I can't get much information.
Did you get her last name?
Shit. No, I didn't. But she said that she's on a ranch or some kind of farm or something. There's pigs.
Okay, she's not dialing 911, so she has to be dialing your station directly.
Okay. Well, can I trace her calls from here?
Yeah, I'm afraid I can't trace a call from that line, but I can start looking into the pigs.
All right, well, what do I do if she calls again? Got it. Thanks. This is Officer Lauren at the old station. I'm investigating a B&E, possible code 9.
I repeat, possible code 9. Sir, you can't be in here. This is a police station. Take it easy. Flashlight and get back down on the ground. Let me remind you, I'm armed.
Answer me! I feel like I'm losing my mind.
Let me out!
Ashley.
Develop self-restraint and be constantly mindful of the welfare of others. I will be exemplary in obeying the laws of the land and the regulations of my department. Sergeant Cohen, this is Officer Lauren down at the old station. I'm calling because I'm calling because I'm happy to be on the force, sir. Thank you.
Can I help you with something?
No, I'm all right.
Well, you can't hang out back here. This is a police station.
No, it's not. The police station's on 14th and Addison.
Ma'am.
You can call me Marigold.
No, ma'am, I will not.
My mama gave me that name. She picked it out herself, swear to God.
Can you please remove yourself from the premises and go about your business?
Look, do you mind if I finish my cigarette? Just feel safer here.
All right, just don't leave your butt on the step.
Hey! You're new, right?
Yeah?
I thought so. I could pick a rookie out of a whole room full of pigs. Well, you still got that look on your face like you give a damn.
Have a good night.
I was here, you know.
Yeah?
Well, the cell next door. But I heard the scream, and they found him the next morning.
What are you referring to?
Well, they brought him in that night. Three of them. It's one to be Manson family. I think they were called the Paynims. Kidnapped and slaughtered those poor girls.
Yes, they did. They also killed the Payman family on the scene of the crime, the officers. I should know, my father was one of them.
Yeah, that's what they wanted you to believe, but they brought him in alive. bragging about what they'd done and all. I can see you don't believe me, but I'm willing to bet my tits and a pack of cigarettes it's the truth. Well, they kept me up all night. Singing this eerie song. Bastard tongue themselves with their own bed sheets. And in the commotion the next morning, I got a glimpse into their cell. And the bodies were gone. But pure evil covered those walls. You okay?
Yeah, no, I'm good.
Well, time to make the donuts. And don't worry, I'm taking my butt with me.
Ashamed of what I do? You ashamed of paying your taxes, taking care of your kids, or loving your wife? I do what I do because it is right.
You ever hit a girl right in the face with a baseball bat?
We dress ourselves in a cloak of ignorance.
She didn't even look like people anymore.
Don't call me sad.
Face swollen. No. Teeth knocked up inside her forehead. It got me excited.
She fell to her knees and bowed to the king.
Are you suggesting we're devil worshippers? Devil's just another bitch of the Lord. Rebel angel that was cast out.
We are all here.
I'm not ashamed.
But he's downstairs doing the Lord's work, just like the rest of them.
Punishing the damned for their sins? That sounds like the Lord's work to me. But the answer is no. We don't pray to him. Hell's been around long before that clip-winged cocksucker got down there. And who do you think was there before him?
He just took a break for a while. Searching the world for pretty faces.
Like me.
Dead people are always like so messy. There's so much
like blood splashing around in there. Make a couple holes and it just pours out.
I once stabbed a girl who sounded like a pig. Me!
She fell to her knees and bowed to him.
That's what pain relieves, you know? It was destined. The king of hell.
The king of hell. There's family back at the ranch. But not enough. Not here. Payman needs soldiers. That's why we're heading home. With guns blazing so he can take his rightful place on his throne.
I am a dancing flame. A lightning strike. A crippling way. I'll destroy your home. The ones that lie within your heart. The ones you pray for. I will rape your humanity until forgiveness is what you seek. for me.
I like you. I won't come back for you and all you love. Mark my words.
I like you.
This is Officer Lauren. Monica?
They're dead.
Monica, is that you?
They killed
them. Who's dead, honey? Who's dead?
The other girls.
What other girls?
You've got to help me.
Okay, Monica. I can't do anything for you over here. I need you to hang up and dial 911, okay? Can you do that for me? What's your last name?
Young.
Young? How old are you?
17.
17, okay. Monica, I'm at a station that does not have the ability to track your calls, so I need you to hang up and call 911. Okay, be very quiet and be very still and listen to my voice. Are you listening to my voice? I need you to go somewhere safe. I need to find somewhere where you can call 911. Okay. Well, then you listen to me, Monica. Listen to me. You need to get yourself to safety. You need to find an opportunity to run and you need to take it. You need to run as soon as you can. Okay, listen. I have a question for you. Has anybody there mentioned the name John Michael Payman? Have you heard that name? Can you think and tell me that? Has anybody asked you? Or have you heard the name John Michael Payman? You think so?
Please help me.
I'm gonna help you, I promise you. Stay on the phone with me, I'm gonna help you. This is Officer Lauren at the old station.
Yep, we spoke earlier.
Yeah, we did. I got her last name. It's Young, Monica Young, and she's 17 years old.
Great. Anything else?
She's not able to dial 911 from her phone. Also, she said there are other girls there. She thinks they're dead, and she said her captors are singing a song.
Okay, a song? Is that it?
I think the remaining members of the Payman family might have her. Hello? I recognize the song.
Okay, slow down, rookie. Look, the Payman family, they scattered and they're under constant surveillance. Do you have a pen?
Yes.
Write this down. John Victor Ida, 15263.
Okay.
If you get any more information, you reference that report number when you call back.
Okay. Thanks. guys are fucking with me. All right, enough. You guys, you got me, all right? The joke's on the rookie. Ha ha. Real fucking funny. Yeah, it's real fucking funny. Mount, shitheads! You guys are a bunch of fucking cowards. Unbelievable. You got me pretty good, I gotta say. You got me pretty, pretty good.
So?
So? What?
Is it just you, or are there others?
No, it's just me.
Oh, that's real fucking mature.
I'm not following you.
Is this like your thing? Is this what you do with your friends? You put every rookie through this little fun house?
Well, I don't think that we're on the same page. I came over here to check on you. I'm Officer Ryan Price.
You're not fucking with me.
No. I swear all my life. Can I come in?
Yeah, I guess.
Okay. So, first night?
Yeah. And you know.
Oh, just the blinding gleam off of your uniform is kind of a dead giveaway.
Well, you came to check on me, and you've checked on me, so now, if you don't mind, I actually have a lot of work to do.
Oh, yeah, you seem super busy. Wait, what was that? It was like a frown smile. Was it like a frial?
All right, so what's your story? You got the short end of the straw, or you just got really unlucky?
Excuse me?
Well, someone made you come here and check on me, right?
No, I don't know. If you ask me, I'm feeling pretty lucky.
Well, to be honest, I don't completely mind the company.
Rough night, I take it?
Yeah, you could say that.
That sounds terrible. What happened?
Well, let's see. There is a crazy homeless man in holding as we speak. He pissed all over my lobby. It's not really funny.
It's kind of funny.
Actually, it was pretty gross.
Gross. I once had a perp shit all over the back seat of my squad car.
Well, you win.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Listen, honestly, when I found out you were working this shift, I snuck away to come see you. I knew your father.
Were you with him that night?
Yeah, I was there. When that payment fuck sh...
It's okay.
No, I'm sorry.
No, it's okay. I want to know they never disclose the details.
He and I arrived early on scene, and we were ordered to wait for backup. But we could hear these poor girls just begging for their lives. So we went in, and they opened fire. And I was able to pull out four girls while your dad held them off. They killed six more girls and two officers, including your father. He was a good cop. And he'd be so proud of you. Listen, I really have to go.
You really don't have to go. I didn't mean what I said. I'm sorry if I was rude. You can stay.
No, trust me, I'd love to. But if you need anything at all, just give me a call and I can pop right over and check on you. Do you remember my name?
Officer Price.
Right. I'll see you around.
Officer Price?
Father, the truth will be free. mountain I'll be guided until I do see. I am safe in the arms of my master, my king. On the last day I will follow, my soul I will bring. From your
Sir, this is Officer Lorne.
Is the place on fire?
No, sir.
Are you dying?
No, sir.
Then why the fuck are you calling me?
I'm seeing things, I think.
What?
Like, I just don't know if I can finish the end of this shift, sir. You'll see me at the end of the shift, sir.
Good. And don't call me again. This is Joe.
Hey, Joe, this is Officer Lauren. What time are you guys going to be down here?
Lady, I am knee-deep in shit right now. Look, I told you I would call you back if things changed.
All right, well, I'm going to be waiting for you outside in my squad car, okay? Thanks, Joe. You escaped?
I'm running.
Okay, okay. This is good. This is good. What's around you?
What?
Okay, what else?
Wait. There's a sign.
Okay, what does it say?
Cobb Roller Road.
Perfect. All right, is anybody following you right now?
I don't know. I think so.
Okay, just hang tight, okay?
No,
I'm not going. I'm just going to call dispatch on my cell phone. I'm going to get a unit over to your location ASAP. You there?
I'm gonna die, I know it.
You're not gonna die.
I don't wanna die.
You're not gonna die. Monica, is there anything around you can use as a weapon? Yeah, this is Officer Lauren. Please reference John Victor, Idaho 15263.
Officer Lauren?
Yes?
We spoke earlier regarding Monica Young.
Yes, I have her location. I got in touch
Officer,
with her.
Officer, she's dead.
What? No. I literally just got off the phone with her.
No, she's been dead for a year. Officer Lauren.
Yes?
She was the last victim of the Payman family massacre. Her body was found in the woods, beat to death with a baseball bat.
I don't understand. I was just speaking to her. I was...
Look, there were only three family members linked to the murders, but there were over a dozen more living in the commune. Maybe you were right. There's a chance that the calls are coming from one of them playing a sick joke. Or...
Or what?
This is just between the two of us, okay? Nobody likes to talk about it in the department, but it was more than just rusty pipes that got us out of that building. Family wasn't killed on the scene like the news said. They committed suicide in holding, and after that, well, things started happening. At first it was small, like the lights turning on and off, missing evidence, abnormal sightings. Pretty soon we couldn't house perps in our own cells without them freaking out. The captain had enough and he pleaded with the county.
I gotta go. Mom.
I was wrong to bring up your father.
Oh, shit.
Everything all right? Jess?
I gotta call you back.
I just didn't like how we say goodbye.
I gotta call you back, Mom. Bye. Hey!
I don't think you realize just how lucky you are to be a part of all this.
How do I know this is even really happening?
Do you see this gun in my hand?
Maybe that gun is still in my belt. Maybe I'm talking to a wall. Maybe I've gone as batshit crazy as I think you are.
I could pull the trigger and we could find out. If crazy is being devoted to something you love, then I'm as crazy as a slimy snail in a tin can. I would do anything for him. I am a little jealous that he took those two bitches with him that night. Should have been me. I forgive him. I can never stay mad at John Michael.
You need to give me my fucking weapon back.
You need to shut the fuck up! Have you seen him here tonight? You have. I knew it. I felt him. Tonight is the 1-year anniversary of his death, and I'm here to celebrate it. So...
dead.
This isn't real.
It is, baby. So proud of you. You're just like your old man, you know. Strong, dedicated, loyal to the job.
I did it for you.
Then why are you trying to leave, huh? I laid down my life for this job. I expect you to do the same.
I'm sorry, Dad. I'm really sorry. I just got really scared. But I won't leave, okay?
That's my good book. Now the man that took your father's life is still in this building. I want you to do something about it.
Dad? Dad?
Hey, how'd you get out, huh? Get on your knees. All the way down, come on. Hands behind your back.
Fucking killing me, man. This is Jessica Lauren at the old station. I'm in need of assistance. I repeat, officer in need of fucking assistance.
Oh!
alive, I'm not fucking with you.
True to the ethics of the police service. I will constantly strive to achieve these objectives and ideals, dedicating myself before God to my profession. Law enforcement. Daddy. Who's coming?
Thank you. and in need of immediate assistance. I have a
Fire.